Happy afternoon, all of you. I am Professor Anand Kumar Das. I was discussing under business organization and management the very first topic, what is business and business activities. That was taken from the very first chapter, as I remember. And I have already uploaded 4 videos on that on my YouTube channel. Please don't forget to watch that. And don't forget to subscribe and give your feedback in terms of compliment, comment. And if you wish any other video other than this, as per your choice under commerce and management part, you can request me for that also. So thank you so much. Let's start with this part. This is match the following. Can you match that? Pause this video. First of all, pause this video and try to match what is the definition of consumer with the help of this. These are the prompts. Say for example, prompt means helping word, helping sentence, which you prompt, which help you to make a particular big sentence or small sentence or anything else. That is prompt, helping word, a helping sentence. So consumer, purchase, article. What does consumer do actually? What is the role of customer? Buy goods. What is the role of client? Buy, purchase, goods, article. What do you think? Pause again. I will request you all pause this video. Very simple. Try to find out what is the relation between consumer, customer, client. First of all, you are supposed to know the difference between consumer, customer and client. Okay, I am going to tell you all. Consumer means we all, as an individual, I am also a consumer. Okay, what we don't do, we never buy anything for resale again to anyone. Okay, clear it? We never buy anything to resell it to anyone. As an individual, we never buy Coca-Cola bottle, we never buy any rice, any dal or something like that, pulse, okay, to sell anyone, to resell to anyone, okay. This is clear, very clear. That is why we are consumer, end consumer, end product actually. From retailer we are buying and then we are consuming itself, but not for resale. But when anyone is buying or purchasing goods or article for reselling to someone else, they are known as customer. They are reselling. It means wholesaler, carry forward agents, distributor, wholesaler, who are directly buying or purchasing goods from the company, they are customer actually. Very specifically, remember this. Don't forget, this is interview question also. When you will appear for any interview, as a ICOM, a BCOM, a MCOM or MBBA graduates, they will ask in the interview, what is the clear-cut difference between consumer, customer and client. You are supposed to tell them very frankly, sir, consumer means we as an individual, when we are buying or purchasing any goods or article, we are never supposed to resell again to anyone. That is why we are called consumer. But customer is carry forward agent, distributor, wholesaler, there are several names. Those who are directly buying from the company, selling it to the retailer. Don't forget, retailer. Okay? And then retailer, from the retailer, goods are coming or products are coming to us, to the consumer. So, customer means carry forward agents, distributor, wholesaler, especially wholesaler, we know wholesaler very well. Wholesaler, those who are buying directly from the company and selling to the retailer. And from the retailer, we are buying as an individual, as a consumer. And for every need, wants and demand, if you are approaching your consumer, a customer, every time they are client. Say for example, I'm a trainer also, I'm a national, international trainer. There are more than 1,000 colleges who are my client. Because for every need, wants and demand, they are coming to me only. For any workshop, whether it's a 1-day workshop, 2 hours workshop, 4 hours workshop, they are my client. That is, for every need, wants and demand, they are coming to me. So, client may work as a consumer also. Client may go to customer also. It's up to them, how they deal with them. But consumer never resell. Customer always resell to the retailer, that is where they are customer and they are directly buying and purchasing from the company. Now, how you will match that? So, by the very definition itself, very clear. Consumer means consumer is as an individual, always buy products, है ना, products or goods but goods we will never use for this article. So consumer buy products article. Article means when we buy in a small quantity, because as an individual we never buy 1000 quantities of Coca-Cola bottle or 1000 kg of rice, maximum 5 kg of rice, 5 kg of flour, of 5 kg of pulse or something like that. We never buy 1000 quantities. When anything is being purchased in bulk quantities, that is being done by customer only. So customer is purchase. Customer always purchase. When you are buying anything in bulk, for that we are supposed to use the word purchase. When we are buying in small quantities, we are supposed to use buy, not purchase. Okay, purchasing for bulk quantities, buying for small quantities. And for buying products and article, and when we purchase, we always purchase goods, never article and product. This is the simple difference between consumer and customer, and client is the combination of both consumer and customer. Very simple. This is all about, with the help of prompt, you might have got actually what exactly is the concept behind consumer, customer and client. I think, or if especially you think my logic is correct, again, I will repeat, don't forget to subscribe, forward to your friend, family, friends, my channel, and don't forget to give me a feedback in terms of compliments and comments. Thank you so much. May God bless you. The happy beginning.